हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस पार्ट वी विल डिस्कस ऑन द न्यू चैप्टर मॉलिकुलर बेसिस ऑफ इनहेरिटेंस ऑफ प्लस टू बायोलॉजी। मॉलिकुलर बेसिस ऑफ इनहेरिटेंस इन प्रीवियस चैप्टर वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ इनहेरिटेंस एंड वेरिएशन। In this chapter, Mendel showed that there are some factors which are responsible for transferring the traits, and later these factors are known as genes. As we have already next studied, genes are made up of DNA, because genes are the segments of DNA. In this chapter, we will discuss on structure of DNA, replication of DNA, and how the RNA formed from DNA, that process known as transcription. Then RNA changed into protein, that is known as translation. And during transcription or translation, how the genes are regulated, those system or those operand or known as lac operand, tryptophan operand, and then human genome project and DNA fingerprint. Firstly, we discuss on genetic material. What are the characteristics of genetic material? Characteristics of genetic material. एक जो genetic material है उसके क्या क्या features होने चाहिए? How we can say that these are the genetic materials? The genetic materials have the ability to replicate, means during the cell division, the genetic material may be copied and then divided into two cells. First characteristic is, it has the ability of replication. It means formation of its copy. The genetic material के अंदर replication की property होनी चाहिए. Second, it shows stable mutation. It shows stable mutation is small scale variation, and those mutations are maybe they should be inherited, and mutation should be inheritable. And third one, it should be show translation process, so that it can change, it can transfer the information by the transcription process. It should be able to translate to transfer the information by transcription. The word transcription and translation, the process in which RNA converts into protein, RNA changes into protein, that is called translation. Transcription, the process in which formation of RNA from DNA, means translation. Conversion of mRNA, messenger RNA, to protein, that process is called translation. And transcription, formation of RNA from DNA, that is called transcription. Later we will discuss briefly about translation and transcription. These are the characteristics of a genetic material. Firstly, the genetic material may be show stable mutation, and those mutation may be inheritable. It has the ability to replicate. And next one is, it should be able to translate, and these information sent from passed from one to next by the transcription process. These are the characteristics of genetic material. Genetic material, firstly we know that nucleic acid. We'll discuss on nucleic acid. What do you understand by nucleic acid? Who discovered the nucleic acid? There are two types of nucleic acid. One is DNA and other one is RNA. DNA stands for deoxyribonucleic acid. And RNA stands for ribonucleic acid. DNA, it was firstly discovered by Friedrich Miescher. DNA was discovered by Friedrich Miescher in 1869 in a first cell. Firstly, the DNA was observed or discovered by Friedrich Miescher in 1869 in a first cell. He saw that this chemical substance present in nucleus, so he called it nuclein. He saw that this is present in nucleus in a eukaryotic cell. So he called it nuclein. Later the other scientist Altman, he showed that the nuclein has acidic in nature, so he called it nucleic acid. Later Altman in 1889 showed that the nuclein has acidic in nature. So he called it nucleic acid. Nucleic acid was proposed by Altman in 1889. This nucleic acid, the term DNA was proposed by Jacques. DNA term was proposed by Jacques. Means this nucleic acid, the term DNA was proposed by Jacques. So the nucleic acid, DNA and RNA later known as. DNA term was proposed by Jacques. Clear? Then how, where is the DNA and RNA present? DNA found in eukaryotic cell in nucleus, cytoplasm. Because in cytoplasm there are two organelles such as plastid and mitochondria present. Cytoplasm, mitochondria and plastid. And RNA, basically RNA is the transfer the messenger, because RNA converts into protein and that is known as translation. So RNA is found in cytoplasm so that it can transfer the information. it is found in cytoplasm. To transfer the information through translation. There is no doubt DNA is also present in prokaryote, but in prokaryote it is present in the cytoplasm. So we have already discussed in eukaryote it's a nucleus. If the cell is prokaryote, there is no nucleus membrane present, then it is found in cytoplasm. Clear? Then what are the components of nucleic acid? The components of nucleic acid. There are three components of nucleic acid. Ribose sugar, nitrogen bases, and phosphoric acid. So there are the three components of nucleic acid: ribose sugar, which is made up of pentose sugar, and nitrogen base, phosphoric acid. Ribose sugar is basically two types: DNA and RNA. In next part, we will discuss all these components. Clear?